How do I keep my email address when I change ISPs? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is a very common question. Quote, is there a way to keep my email address when I change my ISP? The question probably comes up because the email address you have was assigned to you by your ISP. And if that's the case, then probably not. It's one of those things where, yeah, there really aren't any good solutions. However, there absolutely are ways to prevent this from being a problem the next time you change ISPs. In the United States, mobile carriers for telephones are required to actually let you keep your phone number. So if you change from one carrier to another, you keep the same phone number. And in fact, many of the times you're actually allowed to port now your landline phone number to a cell phone or vice versa. Unfortunately, nothing like that exists in the email world. So if your email address is assigned by your ISP, which normally means that you've got an email address that ends in something like @Verizon.net or @Comcast.net or @whatever your ISP is, then yeah, that's stuck with your ISP. When you leave your ISP, which typically is because you've left their service area, most of them do not have any facility to continue to use that email address. Those email addresses are for their customers in their regions, and once you move out and are no longer their customer, then yeah, the email address goes away. There are a very few, that will let you continue to have an account with them, even though you're not in their service area, just to keep your email address working, but it typically costs, it's typically not cheap, and it's also typically not something that a lot of the ISPs even consider providing. So how do you prevent this in the future? Well, the important thing is that you get an ISP independent email address. What does that mean? Well, there are a couple of different solutions. One, and honestly, probably the most common, is to get an email address at a service like Gmail or Yahoo or Outlook.com or ProtonMail or any of a number of email services that aren't associated with your ISP. They will continue to work regardless of where you are, regardless of what ISP you use, regardless of where you are on the planet. That's why so many people, for example, are using Gmail addresses. Now, most of these services are free, and there are some drawbacks associated with having a free email account, but there are also paid services if this is something worth looking into. Another solution is what's called mail forwarding. This is very similar to having a free email account, but rather than actually using the free email account, you configure the account to automatically forward email sent to that email address to whatever email address you would rather receive the email on. That would allow you to continue to use an ISP assigned email address, but then change where the forwarding goes if you later change ISPs. This isn't nearly as common as it once was, and honestly, the best solution for forwarding is to get a free email account to set it up anyway, but there are some dedicated services that will do that. And finally, the solution for all solutions, the solution that I use, the solution that honestly, if email is something that is ultimately going to be important to you for a very long time, and especially if you run a business, get your own domain. By domain, I mean the part after the at sign. What was your ISP's name after the at sign? Have it be you. Just like I own askleo.com, you can own a domain name. And what that means is that any email address on that domain name is under your control. And it's yours forever, for as long as you own that domain name. You can have that domain name email managed directly by an email program on your desktop or maybe by your registrar, or another approach is to use a free email service like Gmail to quote-unquote service the email address that you've selected. Again, I own askleo.com, but all of my manipulation of askleo.com email, it happens in a Gmail account. It's actually not that hard. And if Gmail ever lets me down, I can switch to Outlook.com or Yahoo.com, or I can just do it myself and host my own mail server. The point is, by having your own domain and your own email address on your own domain, not only are you completely freed from the whims of your ISP should you ever need to change your ISP, but you're also completely released from the whims of all the other email providers because you can change them at a drop of a hat. I hope that's helpful. I hope that gives you a direction to avoid the problem in the future. For updates, for comments, for links, and more, visit askleo.com/1860. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.